herb. Herb is a plant. I mean, herbs are good for everything.
Welcome to Eugene Cannabis TV. You made the trip. We're up to episode 771, and I have a very, very special guest, Roger McConnell, who goes by the handle of Sticky Mouse, and we'll be talking more about his life in cannabis and how his connection with Eugene Cannabis TV, among other things. But the first thing I wanted to talk about real quick is musicians in general. I run the Hemp Fest for 12 years, and I have the deepest respect for musicians, because musicians is what really, really made our event take off and brought the people in. And we were completely volunteer. We couldn't pay anybody any money, and so we had to just get what we could get help where we could find it. But cannabis is such a popular subject that it was amazing that we seemed like we always could find people, good musicians that were willing to help out. We had a band one time come down from Corvallis, a Grateful Dead cover band. Oh, they were fantastic. And I kept telling everybody, okay, now we're volunteer, we can't really pay groups, you know. Well, we had the band come down from Corvallis, and they asked us if we could give them gas money. Well, how can you, when somebody's coming down with all their equipment, coming down all that way, how can you say, well, no to gas money? So, okay, so we always made sure we got to get, you know, pay some gas money to help these guys out. But anyway, I just, a big shout out for many of the musicians, and we'll be having them on over the years again. And again, Roger was on many years ago. We're not exactly sure how many years ago, but it was easily 10, maybe more, maybe 12 or maybe or something, I don't know.
I'm thinking more like 15. It was before I had my children, and I got a 14-year-old now, and that was way before his time.
Because we started basically about 2000. 1999, 2000, right in there. I think I became a co-host in 2000, I think it was.
Yeah. I think I was there pretty much in the beginning, so.
Yeah, yes. And Eileen Erdelt, I think Eileen is one that you met. Did you meet Eileen? Is one that you met originally about coming on the show, wasn't
exactly,
it?
Yeah. Yeah. I used to partner up with her on several shows.
Yeah. Yeah. Yes, yeah, and Eileen's been back over the years, on and off, and stopping for a visit, you know. Yeah. And her son, Collie Love, which is a big part of the production, because he was just a little guy, and she would bring him in, and he had the run of the studio, you know. And while I was off camera, we'd be playing. I always had a roll of tape, you know, so I'd roll that roll of tape around. Oh, we just had a ball playing a roll of tape, you know. And, it was some really good times, but and then, you know, I had to tell this story too about Roger and the theme song. Our theme song, Roger wrote the theme song to Eugene to the Cannabis Show, and we've lost it over the years. And I was always thinking, well, someday I'll find it in one of those VHS tapes. It'll be on one of those, and I'll find it someday. And turns out that we already had a copy of it. It was on show number 420. Kevin found that clip somewhere and put it on the show number 420. So think about it, folks. Go to Eugene Cannabis TV. I mean, go to YouTube and look up Eugene Cannabis TV and then pick episode 640. I mean, 420. Blah, blah, blah. Anyway, check out 420, and about 16 minutes, you'll see Roger doing the original song. Yeah. And Roger has updated it and redone it. And so after the... we come back on the second break, we're going to hear Roger doing it. But in the meantime, we wanted to talk about cannabis and the old days and experiences with cannabis and, of course, your cannabis story, because that's what the main thing I like doing here is having people come in and tell their cannabis stories.
Okay. Yeah, well, we've been through a lot since... Since the 70s, 80s, 90s, and experiencing... all the changes that, all the laws that have changed.
And you told made telling it more your son accessible. About what it was like a little bit?
Yeah, explaining to my son, who's 14 now, that, you know, it was quite different back in the day. We did time for that kind of behavior. Mm-hmm. People lost their freedom. And so it's taken for granted by this generation to a degree, not knowing the extent of what a lot of people had to go through to get it to where we are now.
Drug war POWs. Yes, that's what I like to refer to them as. Sean Fleury, I don't know if you probably don't know Sean Fleury, I don't think, but Sean's been on the show a number of times, and Sean is another real advocate for medical for marijuana patients. And Sean was a medical grower before there was even a medical program, and he went to prison for it. So he's a real, he's a real deal, you know. And his heart is in it, and so there's so many people like that. He did a video that we played many times on the show, a simple way to show people how to do an outdoor grow. It was beautiful, the basics. This is basics. You need three elements for your soil. You mix it in a kiddie wading pool. You know, a little cheap wading pool?
Right.
Yeah, you put all your ingredients in that and get a hoe, and then you stir it up. And that way it gives you a good area to mix it up, you know, and then you scoop it up in the bucket and then put it in your hole. Anyway, I had the whole thing about how to do it, how simple it was, you know.
Yeah, mix in a little bit of love and care. And
I tell people it's called weed. That's why it's hard to kill it.
Right.
It's just hurt. It wants to grow. Yeah. So, but however, the irony of it is, you know, I thought to myself, I've been working on legalization for 20 years. And here we are, it's legal. Of course, I always say it's not legal until there's the same controls as tomatoes. But it's still pretty close to legal. Now I lost my train of thought. But anyway, it's a lot better than it was as far as legality. It's further decriminalized, you know, so. And you mentioned your cannabis has helped you and your family and all aspects of your family.
It sure has. I was a grower for a while, which helped sustain our livelihood for several years. Mm-hmm. Very helpful.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
In that aspect. And then, of course, just the medicinal aspects, too. Mm-hmm. You know, it's been a big plus in my life, so I'm just so grateful and honored to be part of the herbal movement.
Yes, exactly. I started out as a freedom issue. The whole thing to me was it's a freedom issue. Then I became aware of medical, and I thought, and you know, I was amazed with that. And then I started learning more about industrial. Mm-hmm. My gosh, it's amazing. It's absolutely amazing. It just kind of took off on its own, you know.
I got to free up the plant, let it do what it can do.
Right, and hempcrete, now they're working with building with hemp.
Right.
And Kathy Ging, I don't know if you know Kathy Ging, but Kathy Ging is a local activist here, been here for many years, been on the show multiple times, big supporter of the Hemp Fest, and she's real big on that. But making hempcrete and not using all kinds of forms. Mm-hmm. They're making big building blocks out of it, and there's all kinds of different stuff.
Yeah, I think Condi was involved with that.
Yeah,
back
Condi
in the
was
day.
Involved, and then also Condi and Dave Sieber, they developed a hardboard made out of hemp, it was incredible. And then Dave Sieber went on to invent a deck stain called hemp. I can't remember the name of that. But anyway, it's all hemp. And it's incredible because it's a deck stain, and yet you can clean up, but yet you can clean your tools with water.
Oh, my goodness.
So, it's quite a product. But of course, I should say now, he passed away, unfortunately. That's one of the problems with many of our heroes and pioneers are passing away as we're getting older, you know.
Right.
And
lose the battle unless someone takes the torch.
Yeah. But anyway, Lisa, the hemp is legal now. And of course, one of the stories that I always enjoyed was the one that came out of Southern Oregon. This group formed a company, and they said that they admitted they were a little short on time, so they didn't get their fences built as sturdy as they wanted, but they put in their first hemp crop, and within a few days, it was devastated. The local deer ended up eating about 60-80% of the plants, you know, and which struck me as funny, and because the first thing you think of is, oh, they like that psychoactive. No, this is hemp plants. There wasn't any psychoactive. They just know what tastes good and what's good for them, you know.
Right, so, right.
Anyway, I thought that was kind of funny. I felt bad for the people, but at the same time, it was pretty humorous.
You know? Beneficial for the deer.
Yes.
It didn't go to a big loss. Like, it wasn't mold or,
right, yeah,
you know.
Yeah,
so,
yeah.
You know, deer's got to eat.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. So you mentioned Hawaii. Now, how did that work out with cannabis, and how did you end up in Hawaii?
Oh, well, I have family over in Hawaii, and so one year that I grew, I managed to sell enough that I could get over to Hawaii with my family to join the rest of my family.
That's great.
Wow. Yeah, and I owe it to hemp.
Yeah, that's great. That's incredible. Yep. So what have you been up to music-wise?
I've been pretty busy. I got a few different projects. I play at the casinos with a band called The Cause. Mm-hmm. We do classic rock, Journey, Styx, Rush, that whole era. Mm-hmm. Then I got my own little project I'm doing now, a little three-piece power trio called McRogers Neighborhood.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm ready to hit a few festivals this summer and make a splash with that. And just trying to stay busy musically as much as I can. I got a little jam I do at Twisted River on Sunday nights. That's on Main Street in Springfield. Mm-hmm. It's called the East Side Jam. Mm-hmm. A lot of fun. We have sign up at 5 and we start at 6 and play till 10. Encourage anybody and everybody to come down, be a part of that. It's a cool little community outlet resource to get connected with local musicians.
I missed my usual thing. I forgot to tell everybody to get pencil and paper, because you might hear stuff we want to write down, and there's an example. Yeah. So we sure bring this up before the end of the show, so pay attention.
That's right. We got Earth Dance coming up. I'd like to talk about that. June 18th, and we'll be a part of that.
Oh, excellent.
Got a lot of great entertainment on that bill.
Have you been to the Hippie Museum yet?
I have. Yeah, I've experienced that. Yeah. That's kind of a neat scene they got down there.
Yeah, they've done a lot of work there. I always remember that place as a lost veteran.
Okay.
They've done a lot of work up there. And
that's Normal Bean holding that down.
Yeah, Normal Bean. And then they got the mural in the alley, the George Walker mural.
Yes, yes.
Oh, it's amazing. It's beautiful. I got it on my phone. I was talking to you. It's absolutely amazing. The Hippie Museum, and we'll be talking about events coming up. I went and saw the Big Brother and the Holy Company there. That was one heck of a show.
That's one of my favorites.
Oh my gosh! When that lady did me and Bobby McGee, I'm telling you what, I welled up.
Okay. She was hitting it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh man, I told her. I said, I welled up, and she said, it's a good song. I said, it is. So,
I'm sorry I missed that one.
Yeah. Well, I almost missed it myself, but I finally made it, and it was a good experience. So we got to stop and take a break, and welcome back to the second half of episode 771. You got your host, DanK, here, and we have Roger with us tonight, Roger McConnell, a.k.a. Sticky Mouse, and this is a big moment because Sticky Mouse is about to do the Eugene Cannabis TV theme, the new one. He did the old one and has updated it, and so now we've got the new one coming up, and we're going to record it at a sound studio to make sure we get really good sound, but I want it to be on the show. So anything you want to say about the song? Or
I'm just honored to be welcome back to do it, and hopefully you'll enjoy the new slightly rendition.
That's great. Well, I this is a very big thing for me, I'll tell you that. So I appreciate it. Let's hear it, and then we can talk about it some more.
Okay. It'll clothe the baby, it'll save a tree. So won't you tune in and watch it with me? The time has come, we've had enough. Smithball jail for nature's green stuff. So cannabis with me, Eugene Cannabis TV. Cannabis with me, Eugene Cannabis TV. Gene to me, Eugene Cannabis TV. Sing with me, Eugene Cannabis TV.
Oh, that is so great.
Yeah.
Thank you so much. Yeah, that's incredible. We're going to cherish this for a long time to come. And like I said, we're going to get it recorded in a studio where you got really good sound, and that'll be our opening theme on the show.
Okay.
So you're going to be in infamy? Is that the term? But,
Yeah. Forever in film.
Yeah. Okay. So I'm sure looking forward to letting Eileen know about it, but I couldn't get a hold of her yet, but I know she's going to be excited about it too.
Okay.
And so we have other guests coming on in future episodes that are really exciting. We have an epilepsy guest coming on, a medical marijuana patient. Danbo, I got to mention. Danbo is coming on. Mm-hmm. Danbo has been on quite a few very, very early shows. And then, I'll tell more about the Danbo story when the time comes. But anyway, you told the story about your guitar, and I just mentioned your guitar and how you came by it. I love this story. This is a beautiful story.
This guitar was given to me by my brother, Maurice, who worked at Guitar Center. One day he came into work and he noticed this guitar in the garbage with the headstock broken off. So two pieces and being discarded. But he thought he saw value in it still. Took it out of the garbage, brought it home, and glued it back together. and then he gifted it to me over a campfire, which was very special in itself.
Oh, I bet.
But for him to save it, it's a rescue, and then give it to me was just a blessing. And so.
Well, it not only looks beautiful, it plays beautiful. So that is incredible. And
I think it plays better now than.
Yeah, I'm sure it does. Yeah. And this kind of thing really takes me home because my dad was a musician. He made guitars, banjos. He made guitars, mandolins, and fiddles. Whoa. And played all of them and couldn't read a note.
Okay.
He was amazing. But many evenings we sat around and he would sit and play and sing songs, Mule Skinner blues, and great times. Of course, Cool Water. Cool Water was always a special song to me because there's a line in Cool Water that says, he mentioned the name Dan in the movie, his horse named Dan, that was it.
Okay.
And so, of course, being,
you
know.
Connect.
Yeah, connect to that, you know, so. But Dad would, I remember back in the days, early TV, and he would turn it off in the evening sometimes and pull out one of his instruments and just start doing his music, you know. Mm-hmm. So it was really special to grow up with that. So
I'd like to jam with him.
Oh yeah! Like. Oh yeah! 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 He was an incredible person. So. Yeah, that's I didn't think to ask you this earlier on, but I'll ask you on camera. Is there anything else other than a song that you'd like to do? We still got plenty of time if there's something in particular, or we can still visit and talk about the past. I was just curious. You might have something in mind. That
God, I'll squeeze out a song.
Okay. Okay.
Okay. Yeah. Let's see. Let's do Find My Way. This is kind of a gospel feel to it. It's an original. It'll be available on my CD, soon to be released.
There you go. Great. Okay. Great.
As the sun sinks into the ocean, I confess my love another day as my mind slips into the darkness. I dream my life away. I could see Mother Mary. She carries me to my home. No matter how dark my darkest hour, I know I'll never be alone. Guitar. Shining, bringing me a brand new day. I lift my head up so high, so I'll be sure to find my way. As the sun sinks into the ocean, I confess my love another day. As my mind slips into the darkness, I dream my life away. I dream my life away.
Excellent. Wow. That's great. I appreciate that.
A little rough around the edges.
Where would that come into your repertoire? Where did that come from?
It's one of those songs that just kind of came through me all of a sudden. It was kind of overwhelming as it's an emotional song. Mm-hmm. So... even as I was writing it for I remember the first day, it had me in tears. It was like, oh gosh, this is a,
little bit of
yes, that's right. Tugging on the heartstrings.
Sure. I don't think I've ever heard of a musician that said he cried over his own song. So that's
I figured there might be something to it if I got that emotional.
It's like I was mentioning Sean Fleury. Sean used to speak on the Saturday market about cannabis, you know, and I told him one time, I said, Sean, when you talk about cannabis, I feel like crying. He said, yeah, I know, me too. But that is wonderful, and it sounds really, really good too, that's great. And you said you've got a couple of gigs going, you say, or a couple of...
Yeah, well, I mentioned the jam that we have going on every Sunday at the Twisted River.
And what time is that?
That's 5 o'clock sign up, 6 o'clock start.
Okay.
We go till 10.
Night. Okay.
And that's been going really well, getting a nice, beautiful crowd down there. So I encourage people that are interested to come on down and check that out.
What's the venue again?
That is Twisted River.
Twisted River.
It's 1444 Main Street, Springfield.
Okay. Okay.
Sunday nights.
Yeah, that's great. I'm sure you'll be at the Hippie Museum too at times, I bet you.
Yeah, I'm going to make it down there at some point.
Sure.
You know, especially when I start promoting my CD. I'll be out playing
And they're setting up a studio down there with to do video and the whole bit, and they're going to be doing internet broadcasting.
Podcast, okay.
Yeah, that's a lot of stuff going on.
I'm excited for them.
You bet. And then normally, three of us will get together and get the theme song recorded.
Yeah.
And it's going to be great. And the summer just started, so... We got the Hemp Fest. Of course, I don't have the dates in my head. We got the Hemp Fest. We got one Hemp Fest in Oregon still. It's okay. Down at, it's in Oakland, Oregon, just north of Settlement.
Right.
It's on private property.
Okay.
And the guy's name is Nathan. I forget his last name, but nice guy. I met him and his wife. He came up to my Hemp Fest one year. Very nice people. And I asked him, I sent him a note, and I said, what's your dog policy? And he said, well, we say no dogs, but if you keep them in camp, as long as you keep them in camp, it's cool. You know? We had a dog policy at the Hemp Fest, too. And we wrestled that for a long time, trying to figure out what to do with the dog policy, you know. And finally, after a few years of doing the Hemp Fest, all of a sudden I thought to myself, we already have a dog policy. The park has a dog policy. Keep control of your dog. That's the policy. So that's what we did.
Right.
We just said, all right, you can have your dog here. Just keep him under control, and you're responsible for him. And we never had a problem with the dog after that.
Mm-hmm.
So, but anyway, yeah, so... Springfield scene. So that's the great things are happening. Downtown Springfield was dying, and now it's really seems to be coming back. A lot of stores down there and eateries. Most of the eateries I can't afford, but regardless, they're there. Cornucopia there, you know. And then I can't remember Planktown. Planktown, I think it's called.
Right.
I ate there once. Oh man, that was good. But I haven't been back since. I just was too rich for my blood, but unfortunately. But well, that's good. So be sure to make notes of that. So that was, and there's events coming up for Sticky Mouse, and you've heard being referred, called Sticky Mouse or Roger, which is
well, Sticky Mouse is kind of an old hat that I was well known for back in the day, 15 years ago. Mm-hmm. So it's interesting that you still refer to me as that. Yeah. It's not so much
not
the
so
case
now.
Anymore.
Okay.
No.
Okay.
So it'll probably be Roger generally, but
okay. Well,
I honor Sticky Mouse still.
Yeah, you bet. Well, we got to get out of here, so coming to an end. I appreciate you so much, Roger, and
okay.
What a treat for you to come in. And you're always welcome to come back, and there's something subject in particular you'd like to let me know, because
okay.
we should be doing the show every week, but we haven't been. But we need to be doing it every week. So
okay, I'll see if I can stir up
always looking to tell your cannabis story. So we got to close it down, and we'll be here next time, and more shows coming up.